The Happy Prince. In a northern town, far, far away, there stood a statue of a prince. He had a shining golden body and enchanting blue sapphire eyes. The sword at his hip was adorned with a stunning red ruby. The prince must be so happy, all covered in gold and gems. The townspeople called the statue the Happy Prince. Near the end of fall, a swallow came by and landed on the prince's shoulder. "Oh, it's so cold. I need to hurry to the south where it's warm." At that very moment, a droplet splashed down on the swallow's head. Looking up, the swallow found that tears were falling from the prince's eyes. "Prince, why are you weeping?" "Look at the house across from here. There, a boy lays in bed, very ill. The boy's poor mother does not have enough money to buy medicine for him. Dear Swallow, would you take the ruby from my sword and give it to them?" "I'm in a hurry to get to the south, but I will take the ruby to them for you." The swallow took the ruby in his beak and flew to the boy's house. There, the swallow dropped the ruby onto the lap of the boy's mother. "Oh my! This must be a gift from the heavens." The boy's mother was overjoyed that she could now buy medicine for her son. When the swallow saw her joy, his heart was warmed with happiness. The next day, as the swallow was preparing to depart for the south, the prince called out, "There is a young, talented painter over there who cannot buy food to eat. Would you go and give him one of my sapphire eyes?" The swallow was cold, so he hesitated, but finally answered, "Okay, I'll stay and help you, but this is the last time." Then, the swallow removed the sapphire from the prince's eye. He gently placed the sapphire before the young painter. The young painter noticed the sapphire and began to dance with joy. "Thank goodness! Now I will be able to buy bread and paint." Seeing the young painter's happiness, the swallow's heart warmed even more. Early the next morning, the swallow went to the prince to say farewell. "I must be on my way to the south now. Goodbye, dear prince." But instead of saying farewell, the prince asked the swallow for another favor. "This is my last request. Would you take my other sapphire and..." The swallow, puzzled by the prince's request, exclaimed, "You want to give it away? But if you do that, you'll have no eyes to see with." please give it to that poor girl who has accidentally ruined the matches she was to sell." The swallow silently nodded in agreement and took the sapphire in his beak. When the swallow placed the sapphire in the girl's hand, her face beamed with joy. "Little swallow, you must be an angel from the heavens." Upon hearing this, the swallow knew in his heart what he must do. "I will stay with the prince and be his eyes." From the next day on, the swallow flew all around the town. He found many troubled people and told the prince about them. "Then take a piece of gold from my body and go give it to them." "Yes, my dear prince, I will deliver your gold for as long as I can fly." With the prince's gold now all given away, his body became a dull gray. Soon, the cold, cold winter came. "Dear prince, my body has frozen from the cold, and I can no longer fly. Farewell." The swallow kissed the prince farewell and fell into an eternal slumber. "Oh no! What have I done? It's all because I asked him to stay." The prince's sadness was so great that it cracked his lead chest. "Without its gold and jewels, the statue has lost its beauty." With this thought, the townspeople decided to melt down the statue of the prince. But the next day, the swallow and the prince had vanished. The night before, spirits had come into the town searching.
"What is the most beautiful thing in this town?"
The spirits then found the swallow and the prince, covered in snow. "These two have such beautiful hearts." And with that, the spirits took the swallow and the prince and led them up into the heavens. The swallow and the prince were lifted high up into the sky. There, a warm and heavenly paradise welcomed them. And the swallow and the prince lived there happily ever after. The end.